Cayman Campus sports journalist Seaford Russell Jr. here at the Truman Bodden Sports Complex in Georgetown, joined now by a very special guest, the newly appointed CIAA President, Mr. Delroy Murray. Mr. Murray, it's great to have you here, sir.
Good to see you. Thank you for having me.
Sort of what are some of the immediate plans that you have in place to...
Well, we have a number of challenges, right? What we want to do is to expand the sport from a more or less a high school meet setting with high school, primary school age athletes. We want to make it a more an all-embracing sport, right, which should involve community events, etc. So to this extent, we have, for instance, proposed a meet which would involve the civil service, the fire, police, etc. And then we are looking also investigating the possibility of another meet which should involve like the utility services, Flow, CUC, the Class A banks, etc. In this first year, and then gradually move it on. Right. Certainly, one of the plans we have, which we hope to initiate, is the situation in which when athletes come out to compete, they are earning points on a Grand Prix scale, and at the big meet at the end, we have a runoff for them, etc. Grand Prix meet for maybe the top four in each division. And we really want to get it more community-based. We want to have a district challenge meets, etc. Mm. One of the challenges which we do have is the inclusion of the sister islands.
Right.
Because I don't think we have the track facility there as we have here. And the question of transportation, accommodation costs, and of course COVID is always lingering in the background. But I think that in the last couple of seasons we have omitted them, and I don't think that is good for the development of the sports.
Right.
Right. So we need to get them back into the fold in a very constructive way. But as I said, COVID just lingers and it is just there, you know, like a irritant.
Completely understand. I think pigging back off the Sister Islands in a more immediate stage of things, the districts, are you guys planning to implement?
We are hampered. Yeah, you would have been around, I suspect, when we had district meets. West Bay, Bottentown, Northside. Problem with district meets now is that we had them at the school fields. But for some unknown reason, or reason not clearly made, which to my mind is unconvincing, is that we have put all of these school fields now have these tracks,
right,
which are made out of asphalt, etc. Naturally, you can't run on asphalt,
right,
especially young athletes. So the district meets have taken a beating in that regard. I do know that it was mooted. I don't know how true it is that eventually they will put some sort of rubberized material on top of these this asphalt, which may make it possible then for us to return to some level of district meet competition. But that was certainly a success, and it is unfortunate that right now we can't have any district meets.
Closer to junior competition is the CARIFTA Games, which has been canceled now for the past 2 years.
Right.
Just kind of want to get your perspective on the upcoming CARIFTA Games and what you think we'll...
Well, the CARIFTA Games is slated for Jamaica over the Easter weekend, and there was a meeting last weekend with the LOCs.
Yes.
And it appears to me that Jamaica is moving in the right direction. She's taking all the necessary steps, all the necessary, putting all the things in place, etc. So I am very, very hopeful that we will have CARIFTA Games this year. Unless, of course, there's another variant which throws everything out the window. But certainly the Jamaican organizing committee seem to be on top of things.
Yeah.
They are following the Tokyo model, if I may put it that way, in terms of isolating athletes, etc., and dealing with it if there's anyone who may have, unfortunately, have this disease. Yeah, they take precautions.
Surely some junior prospects up and coming. Devontae Howell comes to mind.
Devontae Howell comes to mind. Aliana Anderson also comes to mind. And there is the youngster Jaden Reed, who is in Jamaica at school at Jamaica College, who also comes to mind as being three of our top athletes. But certainly, I think we have a good hand in in the boys under 20 division, the under 17, there's still some, there's Mikhail Michelin, for instance, who's an awesome talent, you know. And I say Aliana Anderson in the girls is the one who springs foremost to mind, but there are others. And I think we will be competitive, or should be competitive, at this year's CARIFTA Games. The issue then goes beyond that. What happens to a number of these athletes?
Right.
Not a problem, but part of the issues we have to deal with is that a number of our more, shall I say, top-end athletes at the junior level and even at the senior level are non-Caymanians. Mm. They have lived here all their lives. Mm. They have gone to school here all their lives. They have competed only here. They have represented us at the junior level, at the youth level.
Right.
But when we get to the senior level, because they are not holders of Caymanian passports, etc., then we lose them. Now, that means you're losing leadership.
Right.
You're losing experience, you're losing athletes who can act as a role model to the younger ones. But I don't know how we deal with that, but it is something which we are certainly will have to consider as to how this, what approach to be made. And in other sports it was done previously, but I understand there was a backlash in relation to that. But take Aliana Anderson, she's only competed here.
Right.
This is where she calls home.
Right.
Right, and as I say, she is the most awesome female talent that I have seen since Chantel Morrison. Right, and Chantel was an awesome talent. I reflect that Chantel should have been at this Olympic Games, because she'd have been 30 something with the same age as these girls who were winning medals, and she had beaten the Jamaicans square and fair and the Trinidadians and all the rest of them in 2010.
Yeah.
But there it is.